I love being home.
Yeah, I love being home. Yeah. The beautiful thing, I can say that I'm not worried, you know, because I know my family is coming, so I love being home. Amen. Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Eternal God, I just want to thank you for allowing me to be here. As I'm about to break your word now, I ask now, dear God, that you speak in spite of me, speak regardless of me, speak through me, and use me to do what you have me to do now, dear God. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. So this morning's lesson, this morning's sermon, is something that God had given me. Now it's so funny, I had another topic all worked out and said, this is it, this is it. You know what happens every time I say this is it, and I'm ready, God said, no it's not, no it's not. And he says, put that down for a later day. And I thought, this is so good, God, this is good. No, so I put it down. This morning, I was watching, now I never usually catch David Jeremiah, but I got David Jeremiah this morning, and God gave me two messages out of what he preached this morning. So I made sure I wrote that down. Don't know when these two messages are coming though. But he gave me this one, and I could see more than ever why he gave me this one. See that we're going off on our mission trip today. And I haven't forgotten the missions, people. I'm saving that to the end of the service. Don't think I forgot that. Right? So many times, as Christians, we forget who we are and what we're supposed to do. People who visit the church get comfortable. You know how people get comfortable in church? Yeah. So they get comfortable and they get relaxed and they forget why they come to church. Remember, we come to church to meet Jesus. So children of God, Christians, we need to remember we are different from the world. We are the light of the world. And if our light is not shining, how can we lead others to Christ? This morning's sermon is on the inspiration for our dear sister God for our t-shirts. Remember those t-shirts that many of you sent before? And some of you are confused about it. Say, what did they say? Don't go to church? See, pastor hears from God. He knows what's happening. So our sermon this morning, don't go to church, be the church. Now before I even get into my message, I got a golden nugget to give you. Yeah, you know I love to drop them golden nuggets in. So you keep this one here. Now the golden nugget this morning is this. God can inspire anybody in this church. You don't need a degree. You don't need to be special. You don't need to be in charge of the kitchen for 50 years. You don't need to be the pastor. God can inspire anybody in this church. Once it's of God, you need to be obedient and do what he asks you to do, because he's going to hold you accountable for it. You're not answering to me. If it was me, you could get away with it. You've got to answer to God. So make sure he inspires you to do something, you do it. Now, if you are uncertain if God inspires you to do something, come and see me. I'll call him. That means I'm going to pray. And we'll pray together, and God will tell us if this is up to him. So don't worry about it. We all call on God, and he'll tell us. So if he gives you something to do here, work, school, wherever, do it. That's the golden nugget this morning. Now, we resume our regular broadcast. Who is the church? That's the first thing I want to look at. When we're looking at be the church, don't go to church, be the church. The first thing I want to look at, who is the church? Whoa, look at that pretty building. Look at that. That's a nice looking church. Oh, look at that pretty congregation here. Man, I wish I had a congregation like that. Church. Is it the building or is it the people? Ah, that is something we need to look at. So let me help you along the way this morning. Who is the church? Is it the building or the people? Now listen to this. If nobody shows up at 961 Alpha Hawking Road, can this church operate by itself? Think about that. Who opens the building? Who turns on the lights? Who comes for worship? Who preaches the gospel? Who receives the gospel? The people. So then, 961 Talpa Hawking Road is the building or the sanctuary where the people gather for worship. That's the church. The people. Because guess what? I don't care how many years this has been standing here. If nobody's here to operate it, it can't go by itself. It can't work. So we need to understand that. Listen. It points to the fact that the people are the church. Think on this. If this building should burn to the ground, can we still have church? Yes. We can put up a tent right up here. We can have church. We can all gather over by the parsonage. I got tons of room. We can all gather there. We can keep church. We can keep church anywhere we choose. Because we are the church. So this means the church is the people and not the building. Alright. Let's move on to the other part. Since we are the church, I want you to look at this. We are the church, so let's act like the church. Oh boy. We are the church, so let's act like the church. What is our commission? What is our purpose? What did God want the church to do? Simple. This is it. Matthew 28, verse 19. It says, therefore, go and make disciples of what? All nations. That means anywhere there's a church, we should be making disciples. Of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Anywhere people are gathered in the name of Jesus Christ on this planet, even if it's off this planet, I don't care. That's where the church is. And so the church is not the building. Our commission is to get other persons to know who God is. We are to spread the gospel to all nations, in our church community, in our regular community, at work, at school, wherever the church is. Pastor, how can the church be so many places? But when I was in Jamaica, I thought about how the church was in Jamaica. How is that possible? Because I was in Jamaica. And I'm a part of which church? Talpa Hawking Church. When the mission teams go down to Virginia, where's Talpa Hawking Church going to be? In Virginia. What? We're going to be having church here. Yes. The church is the people. So wherever the people goes, the church goes with it. Church is not the building. Listen. The church started to meet at people's homes in the Bible. They used to find somewhere to meet, and that's where the church was. Wherever the people could meet, they met. And that's what the church was. And wherever they could sit and talk about the gospel, that's what they did. It didn't matter if it was even a temple. They met anywhere. So the people were the church. We need to understand how we live and be a witness of Jesus Christ is what draws people to God. Not whether or not we have fancy lights and screen and microphones and all of that. It's the life we live. That's what draws people to God. So, don't go to church, be the church. It's something very important. And so let me put that up right now. Don't go to church. That's the part I got most people confused. Don't go to church. This is how they're ready. And then they're ready.
Be the church. They're
like, what? This is not saying don't go to your physical place of worship. That's not what this is saying. It is saying, don't just be a church goer or an attendee. Be what God wants you to be. Someone who has surrendered their lives to God so He can use you. Let me show you this verse. Matthew 7, verse 21 to 23. These are persons who were going to church. They weren't in church. They were going to church. Look at this scripture. Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven. What? But only the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. Are you serious? Let's read some more. Many will say to me on that day, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name? And in your name did we not drive out demons? And in your name did we not perform many miracles? Then I will tell them plainly, I never knew you, away from me, you evil doers. You see, it's more than just coming to church. It's more than operating the sound system. It's more than coming up here and standing and talking to you guys. It's more than being in the kitchen. It is about surrendering your lives to God. Because if you don't surrender your lives to God, how can you say you're a part of His family if you have never given your heart to God? Think about this. You can come to church every Sunday for 50 years. If you have never surrendered your life to Jesus, then you're just going to church. I don't want anybody here to be a church goer. I want you all to be followers of Christ. I want you to be disciples of Christ. I want you to be children of Christ. People who have made a connection with Christ in your heart. Because when you do that, then your lives will show what you have done in your heart. What you've done inwardly will show outwardly. Stop going to church. God wants your heart because He wants you to be the church so He can use you. In other words, stop going to church and be a church goer. Be the church. The church was never invented to be a building. Yes, we use it to worship, but we are the church. So in conclusion, to wrap this up so you understand what I'm saying, our t-shirts represents our call as Christians or servants of Jesus Christ. That's what our t-shirts are saying. It is saying, don't just go to the church and visit the building. It is saying, go to church and be the church. Be the church that God can use you. What is the church? Someone who has given their heart to God and is doing the will of God. This person will be the church whenever and wherever in this world they are, as they are filled with the Spirit of Christ. So when you see those t-shirts and someone asks you, what is this? Don't go to church. Are you crazy? You're a Christian. Yes, tell them, I'm not just going to church. I am the church. I am the church of Jesus Christ. Never, help us never to forget that we are the church. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Eternal Father, and most righteous Lord, sometimes as Christians, we get all upset over things that we don't even understand. And sometimes we think some people might have just put something out there that we were thinking or even saying it, and not even realize the implication that you had inspired them to do this. And sometimes, dear God, some of us who have been Christians much longer get upset over silly things. And if you could just take the time to pray to me and ask, what is it that you're saying through this message? we would have learned a whole lot.
So dear God, we're thankful that we as a church can wear a t-shirt that says to us, don't go to church, be the church. That everyone that reads that logo on us, wherever we are when we wear those shirts, when we go on a mission trip, wherever we go and represent this church, that people would look on that shirt and say, why is this on this shirt? That we can say, we're not worshiping our building, we're not worshiping our sanctuary, we're worshiping a true and a living God. And He has assigned us as His children to be His work tool wherever we are on this planet. And so we are the church of God. Help us to realize that. Help us to embrace that. Help us to understand that, dear Jesus. Help us to really realize that if we keep coming to church and we have not surrendered our lives to You, then we are not a part of the church. We are just like furniture fixtures in this building. We are a door, we are a window that just gets opened and shut on a regular basis. Dear God, we want to be the living Word in Your house of God. We want to be something that is used day in and day out. So help us, dear God, if we are here and we have never surrendered to You, that we give our hearts over to You. So dear God, we thank You now. And we praise You for Your word, which You have given to each and every one of us this morning. In Jesus' mighty name, as He taught us to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom
come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Don't go to church.